उधर अच्छा नहीं आता क्योंकि उधर बहुत जन आते हैं और कैसा भी करके जाते हैं, वो अच्छा नहीं लगता हमें।
Of the nearly 1 million sex workers in India today, an estimated 300,000 are believed to be children. Girls that are kidnapped, tricked, even forced into prostitution, often by the very people who are supposed to look after them.
I remember the first story that I heard about a girl who had been trafficked from Calcutta, basically, across the country to Mumbai. And how she was sitting at a bus stand. It was lashing rain. Her mother had died and her father had fallen ill. She was 10 years old and she was sitting at that bus stand after a day of looking for work, despondent, hadn't been able to find it. And a woman, middle-aged, came and said, "My child, let me help you. You can come work with me and you can have money, you can support your family, and then you can spend just a few days with me and go back home." And basically drugged her tea in the process of that and took her on a train ride that lasted 2 days and sold her into a brothel.
Each girl is someone's daughter, someone's sister, a unique and beautiful person who has somehow ended up here, betrayed, trapped, and for sale.
The life they live right now is not true. It is a lie for them to believe that they have another chance at life. I would want to communicate this with every girl I work with, that this life is a lie, it is a lie, and you have another life to live.
When I was about 18 years old, an Indian friend of our family came and stayed with us for about 3 days. And he was running a home in Calcutta. And he just sat me down on the couch and told me about girls who are trafficked. And I don't know, it affected me so much that I walked around the house for 2 days just crying. From that moment on, when I was 18, I wanted to do something for trafficked girls. I wanted to go to India and work with victims.
With a vision to bring about rescue, restoration, and justice to victims of trafficking, and with a heart for India, Greg and Mala Malstead founded Freedom Firm, a non-profit organization with the express mission to eliminate child prostitution in India. Working alongside local police, government homes, and within the Indian court system, Freedom Firm aims to make a personal and societal impact by focusing its efforts on the recovery of trafficked girls and the prosecution of the brothel keepers who sell them.
The strategy of Freedom Firm starts with investigation. It starts with us finding girls, minor girls, who are in prostitution.
We go to the red light areas. We also have informants. They provide informations. We get information from the police, also from the local NGOs, and our confidential informants. Our team go to red light area or to the brothels, and we try to act as a customer. We identify minor girls. We interview them, and we gather the information. That information we take to the police. With the help of the police, we rescue her and then put into rehabilitation home.
The next stage is what we call intervention, which is essentially rescue. And with information that we've gathered from investigation, we go to the local authorities, to the police, and present that information to them, ask for them to take action.
As soon as the girl is rescued, I'm there with the girl, providing her the support which she requires in counseling or just having somebody with her to understand, and helping the police to be a bit more sympathetic with the girl.
Freedom Firm cannot rescue girls on our own. We do not have the authority to do so. And so without the police, we can't take the next step, which is getting them out of the brothels. The next step, the prosecution, is all about making sure that a case is filed against the brothel keepers, making sure that they're not just slapped on the hand and then let go and the girls removed to a different location.
We do a lot of legal research for them. We prepare witnesses in advance of their testimony. We gather documents that are necessary to establish the age of the minor victim. Part of the answer to this problem, this scourge of forced prostitution and sex trafficking, is enforcement of the law. The laws here in India aren't perfect, but they're actually pretty good. And we found that when those laws are enforced, the practice virtually disappears. And our hope is that the next time a trafficker comes around and comes to a brothel keeper and says, here's a pretty 15-year-old, would you like to buy her? They'll say, even if their conscience doesn't tell them, at least their business sense would say, you know what, this isn't worth it.
The fourth part of Freedom Firm is the aftercare work that we do.
I've always been concerned about what happens to them after rescue. What's their life going to be like? What's going to stop them from going back to the brothel? What's going to keep them out long term? What's going to heal them? And one of my dreams was really to get them into nature, and because I believe that God's creation has a huge healing power, and it can really spark an understanding and a belief in the God that could make something this beautiful. There's got to be beauty left in this world, and it's not just all gone.
This is Mala. Mala was rescued by Freedom Firm in 2007 after investigators found her in the red light district of Pune, a city in western India.
My name is Mala. Udhar se acha nahi lagta wo dhandhe mein. फिर इधर आया तो थोड़ा अच्छा लग रहा है रोज वासी क्योंकि मैं पहले के जिंदगी में अच्छी नहीं आता अभी सब कुछ परमेश्वर के बारे में सब कुछ सोचता है उसका आगे बढ़ सकते हैं हम लोग को उसका आगे उसका द्वारा चल सकते हैं उसका जैसा हम लोग कभी छोड़ के नहीं जा सकते
The long-term goal is that they can get back into society, not return to the brothel, and really stand on their own two feet.
Computer sikhne ka aur school ka aage badh sakte hai.
I'm totally excited about it because I think it can be done.
The problem of child prostitution in India continues. But as daunting as the challenge is, Freedom Firm's work of rescue, restoration, and justice continues as well. And no effort of love or justice is a wasted one.
It's a huge problem. Trafficking is enormous, and it's a monster that's not easily going to fall. But it will, even when there seems to be no response, and even when it seems to be really hopeless, something is at work. And if we keep in the name of love and truth and on behalf of God who loves these girls, we do this work, I feel like there is no ounce of our energy that's wasted, and it's all going to bear fruit in time. There's hope
for the hopeless. Freedom Firm relies on the partnership and support of people willing to give their time, their talents, and their resources to bring about freedom and justice to victims of trafficking.
It's an exciting time, a very exciting time actually, to be a part of Freedom Firm. I feel like we're entering a new stage of our work. I think we in Freedom Firm need the prayer support of others. I strongly believe that this is not just a legal battle, this is a spiritual battle.
Everything that we do is going to bear fruit for them and down the line, and so much more than we can see.
And as this vital work continues, captives will be set free. Justice will be served, and lives will be transformed.
It's a huge challenge, but I think it's doable.